Yeah, bro, you need to come with it one time, man. Shit live as fuck. Yeah, oh, man, we had bad. We was out there being balling, nigga. You know how we do. You know how we do, nigga. Shit, we riding this big nigga $100. We wasn't nothing, man. We had a ball, man. A real talk, though. How you doing, though, man? Shit, man. You know, I just got 5 for Mickey D's, bro. Yeah, man, you know, goddamn child support folk came up that bitch, man, and took me to jail, man, for back child support, man. Yeah, I had a job, but they said I wasn't giving them enough. So, yeah, man, just out here now just trying to sell these cigarettes. You ain't need no square, did you? Okay, yeah.
Did you know that becoming a rapper is the number one cause of death amongst young black men? Have you ever wondered why the incarceration and murder of rappers is so accepted and somewhat celebrated amongst today's society? Today, we're going to explore an example of this phenomenon. Welcome to The Rap Trap, hosted by Ayo Canseco.
Once again, we meet at the Rap Trap. We have another example of the Rap Trap. I'm Ayo Canseco, fearless leader of Ayo Nation and the Man 2 Movement. And this is In Hindsight. I keep on wanting to say YG, but it's Slim 400. That's so fucked up. French Montana, what my man name? Chinch Drugs. It's like it's always a star, and then Meek Mill, Chino. It's always the nigga up under them that get murdered and shit like that. So I can see how motherfuckers be with that whole, you know what I'm saying, sacrifice type shit. So I'm put out an edict. I've already said this shit, but let's do it again. If you're a rapper, this is what the Rap Trap is, though. It's impossible to do. But at this point, you're gonna have to choose between your life and your street credit. If you're an artist and you're starting to bubble, if you die in your hometown, in your home city, it's your own fault. It's your own fault. At this point, we have too many examples of this being done in this exact same way. If you die in your hometown from this point, I've already said this. I said this after your homeboy, Young Greatness. Nigga couldn't even come in for a funeral and they made him into a fucking funeral. So now it's known, everybody knows now. That shit didn't come on. If you get killed in your hometown, your home city, it's your own fault. I've been said this. Because niggas don't want to do the 30-day crime fast. I've made niggas aware of the Rap Trap. It's not all good. I've made niggas aware of the golf course. I've made niggas aware of the three S's. All of these things will go into you saving your own life. Niggas have no control over the demonic. Niggas have no win in the battle between the demonic spirits that possess and control their bodies in these desolate places. You are the only beacon of light in this darkness. There is no one that has a chance of leaving. Not even the biggest dope boy. He can't even leave because this is where he makes his money at. You're the only one who has the chance of getting out of this hellhole that everyone hates, but they're stuck there. They no longer see you as they saw you as a few when you were just like them. Is no longer. You're no longer just like them. You are what they would like to be, but they can't. The relationships you've made, the skills that you obtain, have made you eligible for liberation. At this point, you still being around the have-nots is seen as an insult to everyone that you come in contact with. If you fool yourself into believing that their embrace and their smile is real, then that's just you making the best out of a horrible, dangerous situation. The truth is, the hood will feel a lot better when they don't have to look at someone who's here because they want to be. If I could come outside and go through my hell, it's kind of like this. When I go to jail, when I used to go to jail, I knew that I wasn't going to have no bond because I always have warrants. I'm never coming to court. I'm not going nowhere. So I want to be in this motherfucker. Put me over there in C block. Well, nigga, this murder charge, you know what I'm saying? Big charge. Don't put me down here in J block. You know what I'm saying? Where everybody in this bitch is coming in. You got the white boys that's coming off the 72 hours, the domestic violence, drunk driving, always running to the phone because they got hope. They got hope. They hope somebody answer the phone. Damn it, man. Every 5 minutes, they want to tell you their story. The only good part about it is they not eating their trays because they probably they bond is damn on the way. Now, when it was taking so long, you can have that. No, when it was taking so long to make my bond, oh, yeah, their hands make fucking. When it was taking so long, my bond, man. Well, when I get out this bitch, boy, I swear to God, boy. Shit, boy. No, my bitch waiting on me, boy, I really talk. And the whole time you was around this bitch like, yep. But you knowing you're not going nowhere. You won't, like, not only are you going to have to wait that 45 days for the probation shit, but ain't nobody coming to make no bonds. So you're going to have to sit in this bitch and tell the whole fucking case, the new case you got is adjudicated because you're not bonding out on that neither. Put me in fucking C block, dog. I don't want to be nowhere around these motherfuckers. And that's what you are. You and this bitch, yeah, bro, I'm just down this bitch chilling, man. You know, yeah, me and YG, you know, we over this bitch, you know what I'm saying? This fuck around, we just got back from Rio, man. Man, beautiful out that motherfucker, man, real tall. Yeah, bro, you need to come with it one time, man. Shit live as fuck. Yeah, oh, man, we was out there, bitch, balling, nigga. You know how we do. You know how we do, nigga. Shit, we riding this bitch, nigga, $100. We wasn't nothing, man. We had a ball, man, a real talk, though. How you doing, though, man? Yeah, man, you know, I just got fired from Mickey D's, bro. Yeah, man, you know, goddamn, Goddamn child support folk came up that bitch, man, and took me to jail, man, for back child support, man. Yeah, I had a job, but they said I wasn't giving them enough. So, yeah, man, just out here now just trying to sell these cigarettes. You ain't need no square, did you? Oh, okay, yeah, man, I'm just, yeah, man, just selling these cigarettes, man, and just trying to find a way, man. I ain't got nothing with these cigarettes and this pistol, but I ain't got no bullets for the motherfucker and shit like that, man. That's pretty much it, man. It's really just struggle. You know, my mama just died. Yeah. She was all I had, you know, when I was staying with her. I actually found out about her passing while I was locked up for the child support. So, yeah, man, I'm just trying to survive, man. You know, before they had, all right, man, get with you, man. Like, look, no, what you saying that? What you get? Hell yeah, man. Yeah, man, I just out here chilling with these niggas, man. Ain't nothing to it. You said we going back to Miami? Okay. All right, well, I see you. Yeah, man. And it continues. You got different niggas in different situations, but we've always been. The reason why it's so hard, we know that you can't have too many niggas on a fucking foot, a sports team. You can't have Kobe, LeBron, D-Wade. I don't know sports like that. I do, but not off the top like that. But you can't have too many Kawhi. You know what I'm saying? You can't have too many Curry. You know what I'm saying? Durant. Can't have too many niggas on one team because it's like, it's too many, like, we gon', you know what I'm saying? We are. And that's why you can't understand why. We are at heart, we are alpha males. We're that strong, but, and that's the reason why they had to give us this dope. They had to give us this to make us more docile. To take us out of our natural element. But I don't want to go too far with you. But this is what we are. So when you come telling about your bad bitch, you know, you always got that nigga that the Clips made a song about this shit a long time ago, Mr. Me Too. Yeah, me too. You know what I'm saying? Whatever, you got a Benz, he got a Benz. You know what I'm saying? You got a Puerto Rican foreign bitch, he got a Puerto Rican foreign bitch. You know what I'm saying? You ain't gonna be better than me. And then, so the thing is, my nigga, this is what I ask niggas. So if I'm up like that for real, and I'm not gonna help niggas, first I'm not even come. Fuck that. I'm not staying up here, but I'm not even coming around. While I'm trying to come up, I'm not going to be around niggas. When I get up, I'm not going to be around niggas. I'm around people who are higher than me and hoping they'll take me in and not be afraid of me, because this is our fucking nature. At this point, we have to. What are we doing? Nipsey just got in. We was just, oh, what the fuck, man? Somebody set that shit up, man. Somebody paid that motherfucking man, dog. Who paid the niggas with Troy Ave? Who paid the niggas with French Montana? Who paid the niggas with Slim Duncan? Who paid the niggas Slim 400? Are you saying that you have to pay a nigga to kill a nigga that's doing better than him? You cannot be around these people. They don't like you. These niggas around you don't fuck with you. Niggas understand this, nigga. If you're doing better than a nigga right now at this moment, y'all smoking a blunt, listen to this goddamn video. This nigga doesn't like the fact that you gotta give him a ride home. He don't like the fact that, you know what I'm saying, you gotta shoot him, you know what I'm saying? You better know who the fuck you dealing with. Because as niggas, this is what niggas do, they watch the drone and they'll dap you off. Smile. You doing your thing, King. You doing your thing, boy. Can't nobody do it better. Go get a ratchet, nothing ass bitch and tell this hoe about everything that you doing wrong. Shit, I couldn't have been in that spot. I wouldn't let that shit slide. Not me, I ain't gonna let that shit slide. Nah, see, the thing, I'm gonna tell you what he doing wrong. See, first, when that nigga be talking to the people, see, you gotta look folks in the eye. See, you gotta think about it. On my fucking Instagram, I just told people, I hate when a nigga is trying to convince you about something and he say, see, you gotta think about it. What? Oh shit, that's grand great. Hey look, man, we go live every Monday night at 7:30 Central Standard Time on the Big Facts Podcast YouTube channel. When you come in at live, do not donate to the Super Chat. The Super Chat is that little dollar sign on the side of your comment. Don't fucking donate to that. We have Cash App, we got PayPal, Streamlabs. I've even went as far as to make a Patreon page so that all of the true AO Nation members can become a patron and donate $1 every month. You know what I'm saying? To show love to the fucking show. But there's no reason for anybody to use that fucking Super Chat. They're fucking robbing me blind. For all the new folks and shit like that, if you're trying to get your merchandise, whether it be the Are You Serious t-shirt or the Big Facts Podcast t-shirt or the Men 2 t-shirt or the Big Facts Podcast Scully's. Scully's go for 10, the Men 2 shirts go for 20, the Are You Serious and Big Facts Podcast t-shirts go for 15. Go to paypal.me/areyouserious10. Make sure you put your address on that motherfucker, your size, and the color you want, and what shirt you want. For all my advertisers, no matter if you got a book, actually, for my people who have products, your prices start at $100. Artists, your prices start at $200, and those prices go up to $2,000. Please do not contact me about no fucking business until you're ready to make a transaction, and I'll be more than happy to get on the phone with you. Hey, this is what we do, yada, 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 and we'll go to it. But I'm not doing it. Are you paid on Friday? Dog, I'm already having a fuss at folks for sending me stories that come on. Another thing, don't send me stories to my inbox that the whole world knows about. I have the internet too, so I know the shit happened also. So you don't have to send it like, hey man, you heard about goddamn. Get your shit together, Beyond. I hate that fucking phrase. You gotta think about it. And then they say some shit that you don't even have to think about. But yeah, that nigga ain't doing shit. Nah, see, if you don't watch it, somebody gonna take that spot. Oh, he ain't even treating the girl right, man. See, he doing that girl wrong. They'll find everything wrong with what you do and how they'll do that shit better, but they won't do anything to get in that spot. The most that they'll do to get in that spot is fucking kill you. They won't do none of the work, none of the fucking footwork, none of the relationship building, nothing that the fuck you've done. The hours, the sleepless nights, the studying, the researching, the dead ends, none of that shit. But they will kill you, because logically in their mind, the only way for them to progress is to get you the fuck out of the way. And all you've done is gave. All you've ever tried to do is give, uplift. You know, it's a nigga, King Jim, I said this already, King Jim's from fucking Virginia. This is one of them niggas, and he shares I relate with this nigga. And see, that's the difference between you rap niggas and niggas who rap, and it's just a, you can be a trap nigga who makes that trap music, when it's real, it's felt different. When you, it don't matter what the fuck you rap about. If you talk about, but if we talk about dope, there's little subsections in it. You know this, whip up a brick, yeah, whip up a brick, yeah, whip up a brick, flipping a brick, yeah, flipping a brick, yeah, flipping a brick. It's, how did you get to a brick? How did you get to a fucking brick? Tell me about the dope that you fucked up when you was trying to learn how to cook the shit. You know what I'm saying? How did you cook it? Did you microwave and stove? Where was you at? You know what I'm saying? Was it at your mama's house? Did you do it in the trap house? How many niggas was around? Was it you and your people? He was the plug? Was it a whole bunch of niggas? How did this shit happen? And the nigga, back to King, the nigga King James, he speaks about all this shit. I'm advising everybody to fuck with King James, Black Diamond. I'm on that shit. I can co-sign that type of music. This is the same way Trey HD, Brim D, Aunt D's at AM, these type of niggas. As I'm, you know, thinking about this, how this shit moves and how you can try everything within your power to make niggas come up. But it's some shit that some niggas will not accept. If you did not, there's no way to do it. Because I was going to say, if you did not grow up with a nigga, then he not going to listen to you. But growing up with a nigga will be the exact reason why the fuck he won't listen to you. He can't respect you like a new ear can respect you. We all know the person that you, Katrina Gibbs said this, Conversation With Me podcast, go subscribe to the motherfucking shit, dog. A person that you just met from fucking nowhere will support you more than the people that have known you your whole life and know your current situation and how much that their support will do for you, them to come up. Why is that? Let's not go into that. We're talking about trying to help someone and how impossible it is. The people that you want to help the most, once you get on or get to a position of power, is the people that you've seen suffer all your life. You don't know how to, it don't matter how fucking, it's horrible, you see it on the news, Katrina, Flint, Michigan, these horrible things that you've seen happen, you're still gonna feel like, man, I know somebody right down the street that's fucked up, man. This nigga been walking for years. When I get on, I'm getting that nigga a call. Man, that girl down there, she got fucked up, that nigga goddamn gave her AIDS, man. She down there hoe trying to fucking, you know what I'm saying? She can't even afford her fucking, no weed. She can't afford her medicine and shit like that because she smoked weed. Man, I'm going to get her a whole year worth of that shit, man. I swear to God, ain't folks, everybody want to be Rallo. Getting the whole apartment complex, everybody get to stay for free. It's, you know what, dog? It's really, as I speak about Rallo, but we saw what happened. But the thing with Rallo, a nigga, but that's again with him. He trying to help niggas and niggas fucked him over. That's how you get an informant. Niggas is not gonna let you live, dog. How many times are you gonna have to see this shit happen for you say, nah, I can't do it, my nigga. But it's gonna be you. It's gonna be you, the nigga who, nah, nigga, that ain't how that shit go, nigga. Fuck that bullshit, nigga. Nigga, I'm a rep for my fuck, nigga. That's them fuck, nigga. And then real shit, nigga, my hood love me, fuck, nigga. Fuck you talking about, nigga? It's gonna be you. It's gonna be you. It's gonna happen to you. Because that's what you're showing. Whenever you, nigga, I'm gonna beat the odds. Shout out to Big C. These niggas believe that they're gonna beat the odds. They're gonna be the one who the rule does not apply to. They're gonna be the anomaly. If you're a rapper on the rise, you have to leave. If you won't leave, you're gonna die there. Simple and plain. So let's go back to the original point of this whole thing. I'm so surprised, not by a nigga getting shot in his own hood, because that happens every day. I'm more surprised at the fact that niggas will, I'm not surprised. Like, you cover these niggas because whatever. But you niggas like, yeah, man, no one deserves this, man. We're going to put your prayers up for Slim 400, man, because no one deserves this, man. This is just over nonsense. How the fuck do you know it is over? How do you know what it's over? And who the fuck are you to say this is nonsense that niggas die over? See, that's what I'm talking about, dog. I believe that a lot of you media motherfuckers, y'all should tell the story the way it is on the motherfucking police report and say no more. Hey, y'all, can we stop the violence? Leave it just like this. Don't go into this was nonsense and all that shit like that, because you have no idea what the fuck is going on. That little bit of nonsense, letting a nigga slide with $20, letting a nigga goddamn get off the hook for this little bit, that little nonsense you talking about, can fuck your whole reputation up. Nigga snatching your bill. Nigga not paying you for the cigarette, anything. Not passing the blunt to you. Passing that bitch over you or something like that. Little shit like that. That's what makes you a motherfucking legend. That's what makes you someone with a record that's solidified, like any nigga that you can think of that has a solidified record. It starts from shit like that. Nigga don't take no shit. Nigga don't take no shit. And what happens a lot of time with these rap niggas is a rap nigga get a little bit of money. Rap nigga get a little bit of money, get a little bit of influence, couple hoes want to start hitting him up and shit like that. Now when he walking through the mall, he big boss walking. You know what I'm saying? He really letting his, on some Tekashi 6ix9ine shit, trying to let his fucking nuts scrape the ground. But rap nigga, you just got money. Real street niggas that built the city, brick by brick, been had. So you a new nigga with money, and you, cause you out the loop, cause you lame as fuck, you ain't never had shit. You don't know who the fuck you offending by scrubbing your nuts in certain areas. So you get your motherfucking head knocked off. The real way. Because it's not the rap niggas you have to worry about. It is them too. It's everybody. But a lot of you niggas are broke because God has love for you. Because if you got money right now, you will be dead within the week. Because you wouldn't know how to act on one hand, and you would get murdered for fucking the wrong nigga bitch. Shout out to nigga out there in Puerto Rico or whatever the fuck like that. Or you would kill yourself on the dope. A lot of you niggas are broke because God loves you. You wouldn't know what the fuck to do if you had $1,000 tonight. You will be dead by morning. So that's why you in front of the gas station selling cigarettes. You should be going to church every Sunday and just, but you don't know. You don't know what's going on. You niggas hitting licks, going through old lady windows and shit like that, trying to sell 32-inch TVs and shit like that for whatever you can get, like a fucking smoker. And then all of a fucking sudden, the rap trap pick you up, and you got it. And now you and this bitch talking about big dope, stupid big dope, trap of the year type shit. But nigga, ain't nothing on your record but burglaries. Burglaries. Theft. Every dope charge that you had was possession. You've never had enough dope to get anything over. This rap shit do something to niggas, man. It do something to niggas. So, as a rap nigga, and don't get it fucked up, my nigga. If you rap and you get money from rap, you're a rap nigga. Period, point blank. Ain't nobody, don't nobody get, I'm a poet, man. I'm a street poet, nigga. I'm street lizard, bro. I ain't with that rap shit, bro. I ain't no rap nigga, bro. You get paid from rap, you're a rapper. Period. The issue with the shit is, you won't accept it. You're a rap nigga. Accept it. But another thing is, this rap shit puts a lot of you niggas in weird positions because you're not really getting paid from this rap shit. The nigga, what's the nigga name? From Texas. Go Yayo said he signed the SOD Money Game, not as a rapper, but as a shooter. As a shooter, that means that you're on a record label signed as the person that is supposed to take a murder or attempted murder charge. That's, like I told y'all, it's not a crime until the police get there. You put the police lingo on top of shooter, that's assailant. He's the shooter. Murder, attempted murder. And this is the shit that comes out of your mouth. Because it sounds cool as fuck. But as a nigga who's not quite getting money from your lyrics and your raps, hey, stop that shit. Hey, chill it. Kill. Hey, stop that shit before I throw. Alright. Stop that shit. Stop it. What happens is you're kind of in limbo. So they'll have rap niggas where, and the more and more you try to upkeep the image, the more and more you put yourself in this hot soup. Everybody thinks that you're getting money as a rapper because you try to make it look like it. That's the fuck you gotta do. This is the rap trap. In order for people to pay me for rapping, they have to think that I'm already getting money for rapping. Shout out to my nigga from Making It Magazine, the CEO, the founder of Making It Magazine. Just got to phone him, actually. Think he said it's like a principle. Everybody's at a club and shit like that. You see one nigga on the dance floor dancing, he looks crazy as fuck. Up until the second person gets on the dance floor. Now it's a fucking party. As a rapper, this is the principle that you pretty much live by. You're trying, right now, you're that one person out there saying that I can be a rapper, I have good music and shit like that. You gotta get somebody else that's not your people to fuck with it also. And that second person is pretty much, it's a relative, it's kinda like 200 people, 2,000 people. It has to look like everybody's fucking with you and shit like that. And one way to make it look like everybody's fucking with you is to have a whole bunch of jewelry, big cars, just be living like a fucking rapper. So that now, when a person's kind of, same with the dope shit. If, it can go a lot, it's a lot of different ways with the dope shit though. You selling dope, you want to be fresh as fuck. You want to look like the plug so that the smoker can't come to you with nothing else but the whole thing. But that can play in a different way also because he might feel like, ah, you already got it, so shit. I know goddamn you ain't gonna be tripping about me being short this much. Nah, nigga, I look like you supposed to pay me the whole fucking thing. I ain't fucking no petty shit, man. I don't need that shit like that, man. If you a dollar short, I ain't fucking with that shit. You don't fucking see me, motherfucker. Come with that whole thing, man. Respect me, man. I'm like that for real. What the fuck this is? But that's really what it is. You're trying to get these folk to believe that you should pay for my shit and you should fuck with my shit because you see the way I'm living. I really got it like this. You know what I'm saying? Like off this rap shit. And then also I'll give him simultaneously saying that I'm still in the streets. So it's a real fucked up balancing act, because nobody wants to sell dope. There's no street nigga that wants to sell dope. They'll say it and but give that nigga a fucking real estate business that's already running, he'll put all that dope down. Like, oh no, I'm in that real estate, nigga. Oh no, I don't fuck none of that dope shit, I'm in the real estate. Nigga tell you I sell dope for life, nigga, my shit. Listen to me, ain't no nigga out that bitch that don't want to sell dope. It's just all he got. And a nigga mind, his mind, is not big enough to say, I'll work my body for a little while so that I can show people how I'm working my mind. That means go and work construction for a couple months, couple years, until I have enough to put it into my own real estate business. Because either way it go, you're going to be working construction. You can do it out here and get paid full price, or do it up in that motherfucker and get paid pennies on the fucking dollar. The street shit is wicked. That's why when the fuck you get a chance to get the fuck out the streets, you gotta leave. Niggas will respect you seeing you in studios in different states and shit like that, vibing with other niggas, just as much as they'll respect you being in your own city. If the label has you in a situation, I don't give a fuck if YG did have him in a situation where the fuck he not getting no money, he fucked up, can't get no money no other way, to where you still in the hood and you just a fucking prime target. And it's so crazy though, because as we look at it, he this is the nigga who stepped down on Tekashi 6ix9ine, and that's what the fuck I say. This is what I tell niggas. You cannot do a negative fucking act. You cannot perform a negative action without getting that negative action back. It doesn't work like that. You can't steal a nigga chain and then get graces for it. Oh, Big Motor, Chris P, dog, I'm telling you, bad shit happened to all these niggas that then took niggas' chains and shit like that. Bad shit happened to all these niggas. They were on for a moment, and bad shit happened to all of them. So as you're going to diminish someone else's life, same thing with the nigga GQ Casanova. He came up to fuck over Casanova two times. Something fucked up just happened to him, I heard. But you going, nigga, what the fuck is up? Even though Tekashi was that motherfucker, but all we had to do for Tekashi to kill all that shit was just not fuck with them. That's all we had to do was just not fuck with them. But because we as black people will never come together on any fucking thing, even if we're all going through the same fucking reality, we are the easiest people to infiltrate. Period. There's nothing that we have that another group cannot come into. And you can take that to the most literal point. You will not find a neighborhood where there is not a majority black neighborhood where there is not an Arab business owner that we all must fuck with. The best thing that we can do for Slim 400 and for Nipsey and for all the other people that have met their demise by our own hands, because of our personal situations, is to break the cycle. Once again, I'm asking everyone to join me in a 30-day crime fast. For 30 days, we commit no crime. That means no stealing, no selling dope, and no harming of anyone, especially not a African American. You can either join me or stop crying because you love this shit. I'm not gonna go into how niggas scream this gangster shit. How the fuck do you think this gangster shit is made? We can go into Slim 400 and scream nothing but gangster shit. How he high sided on other nigga. We can go into how the fuck he's a gang member and gang members get killed. Gang members get shot, stabbed. It happens. We can't be surprised about it. This is why we respect it. That's why hoes fuck with them, because they may not be here tomorrow. So they have to live their best life every day, and we appease them in that. No one throws the party, and it ain't a fun life being a school teacher, construction worker, landscaper. You're expected to be at work tomorrow. Every time you leave your gang member, you gotta tell them I love you. Because you don't know when the next time you'll see him. Of course, we'll have somebody in the comment section. You can die there walking out the house. You can die getting in the car driving out. If you don't want to die, go to school. Do something that's not dangerous. If you want to be a gangster, you will be dead in a couple of days. But you won't have any media coverage. They won't put you in a newspaper. You're just gonna die. Nobody's gonna give a fuck. Your homeboys may say RIP, but them niggas ain't nobody, so your name won't even get passed down. Choose your faith. I say a 30-day crime fast. Let's change all that black men don't cheat shit, all that talking shit. Let's show something right fast. We can all get on one page, and we're not fucking animals that just have to be. It's a rap trap. Make sure you hit the PayPal. Show love. I'll see you on the minute. Love.